We have an update for you now on former Conservative Senator Lynn Beyak. She was directed to attend anti-racism training by the Senate ethics officer last year. So what happened next? The CBC's John Paul Tasker is here to pick up the story. Hey, yeah. JP. Okay, so before we get into what did happen next, let's just set up for our viewers exactly why Lynn Beyak had to go to this anti-racism training.
Right, so this all started in March 2017 when she gave a speech in the chamber basically defending Indian residential schools, saying they were in well-intentioned, that teachers didn't mean any harm to some of the pupils who were there. And she also kind of condemned the Truth and Reconciliation Commission for not focusing on the good when it reviewed the Indian residential school system, saying it focused too much on the death and despair. And then she posted a series of letters to her Senate website, basically defending her position. And a lot of those letters had a lot of racist content in them. And so the Senate suspended her because she refused to apologize. They then sent her to anti-racist training, which is how we get to this story today.
So we get to this story. And basically, I remember the last time we spoke about this, there were still questions because she, essentially the way her suspension worked, when Parliament resumed, so did her time as senator. And she put out this letter saying, I've gone to this training. I've done what I was supposed to do. So reinstate me. And that's where this all comes
in. So they suspended her, but they said she could come back if she went into this anti-racism training and apologized. Well, things went horribly wrong at the anti-racism training sessions that she had last fall, and they really got off on the wrong foot when she started by saying that she believes she has Métis ancestry. She believes she can identify as an Indigenous person because her parents adopted an Indigenous child when she was a youth. So she believes that because her family had an Indigenous child in the household at the time when she was, you know, growing up in Dryden, Ontario, in northwestern Ontario, that should allow her to qualify as Métis. Of course, that is a very dubious way of defining Métis. We know that's not how you define Métis. It's an outright falsehood. So that is not how you define Métis, and the trainers in this anti-racism class knew that. And of course, they thought, okay, we're going to have some trouble here because she doesn't quite understand any of the Indigenous history in this country. And beyond that, they tried to have her look over some examples of things that might be racist behavior and try and identify where somebody went wrong. They presented her with one example where a man in Dryden, her hometown, went to a hotel. He had pre-booked a room, but he was turned away from having access to that room with no explanation. Now, we know now that he was a First Nations man. This is a real story. But she said it probably wasn't because he was First Nations. She said it was likely because he had dirty hair and that he was grubby and threatening looking. Well, it turns out the man in question was the trainer's husband. So the trainer knew very well who this person was. It wasn't because of his appearance, and it wasn't because of how he was dressed. It was likely because of his First Nations identity, or at least that's what the case study was. So that immediately turned them off because they said, you can't really talk about people in these terms. You can't really use physical descriptions when you're talking about someone of a certain race. She didn't really pick up on all that. She said that it's clearly not because of that. It's for other reasons. Then it got even more heated beyond the Métis ancestry, beyond these comments about grubby looking First Nations people. She then went on to question the whole history of our country. And she said that the Indian Act was not a discriminatory piece of legislation, which we know now that when it was first enacted, of course, it was designed to segregate First Nations peoples from European colonists and other peoples in the lands. She said that it's not how she interprets the legislation. She believes it was really just an attempt to, you know, spread peace across the land. And the trainer is really trying to push back with her on this first day, trying to educate her on what actually went down in this country. And ultimately, they left it with Senator Beyak saying that we're both well-informed. Neither one of us was there in the 19th century, and we should have to agree to disagree on that. So after a series of other inflammatory comments, they basically kicked her out of the anti-racism training. They said, you can't come back. She was supposed to do 3 days of this. She only made it past the first day, and they said, you're not welcome to come to training.
So really quickly, what happens now, right? Like, this report is then passed on to the Senate as a whole?
Yeah, so what the Ethics Committee has done is reviewed this training report card that she got, and they said, listen, this isn't going to cut it. This is not what we told you to do. We told you to go and educate yourself, learn about what's happened to Indigenous peoples in this country. Clearly, that's not what happened. So they're now recommending they suspend her again. So this Ethics Committee report will go to the larger chamber, and all senators will be able to vote on it. We expect that to happen this week, but something that might be damning for her is she told the trainer during these sessions that this is irrelevant because she believes she will be reinstated anyways, regardless of how she fared in those classes. We'll see if senators actually believe that to be true because they will have the final say on this.
Definitely something to watch this week. Thanks, JP. Hi, I'm Vashi Capellos, host of Power in Politics. See more of our show by subscribing to the CBC News channel or click the link for another video.